Hi there, Megan here. In this video, I'm going to share with you everything you need to know about the CoDrone EDU JROTC Edition controller. There are a few differences between this controller and the standard CoDrone EDU controller. If you are looking for information on the standard CoDrone EDU controller, check out this video here. Your controller is the main piece of hardware you will use to communicate with your drone, whether you are piloting or programming. Let's start off by walking through the controller itself. One of the most important parts is the antenna. It is located on the front of the controller. For the best signal connectivity, the antenna should be extended fully and pointed in the direction of the drone. The USB-C port is also located on the front of the controller, opposite of the antenna. This is how you will connect the controller to your computer for programming. The LCD screen is located on the top of the controller. The LCD screen will display various information regarding your drone, the controller, and its flight. There are two joysticks located on the top of the controller, one to the right and one to the left. Both are used for flying. There are four trim buttons that sit in the center top of the controller. You would use these buttons for trimming the drone when you notice that your drone is drifting one direction or another while you're moving through the air. To learn more about this, check out our video on trimming. The L1 button is located on the front top left side of the controller and is used for taking off, landing, and changing the speed of the drone. The R1 button is located on the front top right side of the controller and is used for changing the LED color of the drone and controller, and also for flipping. The H button located on the top left corner of the controller is used to toggle the backlight on and off. It is also used for bringing the drone back to where it took off from or home. The S button located to the left of the trimming buttons will take you to the settings screen by clicking and holding it for a few seconds. The P button located to the right of the trimming buttons is used for pairing. You can use the S and P buttons to switch between the display screens, which is covered in a later video. The last button on your controller is the power button located on the top right corner of the controller. The controller can either be powered by plugging it into a power source like a computer or by using a battery pack that came with your kit. Regardless of how you decide to power your controller, you'll need to hold the power button to turn the controller on. Now let's power on the controller by pressing and holding the power button for 3 seconds. From here, you can either choose to continue learning about the different controller display screens or check out our video on the different controller setting options.